This video is about the mounting assistant, which is a new feature in PC Schematic Automation from version 19, and it's also a part of the PC Schematic Automation service program. During this video you can see how it works. Normally when you mount a panel, as a Gaia in this photo here does, you'll print out all pages in the project and then you'll go through those pages to find all wires and all other connections in the project. The mounting assistant can help you find all those connections for you. I'll show you what the mounting assistant can do, and I'll show it by using this small project here. It's a door control system and it consists of four pages of diagrams, and it consists simply of a small control panel, the front of the panel, and two control units. One is indoor and one is outdoor, and they're exactly the same. All connections between those parts, you can find them in the diagrams. And normally you'd print them out on a piece of paper and then you would have a marker and mark each wire one by one when you mount it. But now we use the mounting assistant instead. So I start the mounting assistant by pressing this button here. I have a file number, an order number, a case number for this project. It's 117 here. And when I click that, I'll open the mounting assistant. It has two windows. One window with all connections simply lined up in the sequence that you have or the order you have from the project. And then I have this small window here, which is the mounting assistant window. When I want to mount the panel, I can either take one connection from the order of the project, or I could go in and sort it in different ways. One way would be to select by reference designation, and you saw that in this project it's divided into different designations. That could be either the control panel itself, it could be indoor control unit, outdoor control unit, and what I would have if I use this order here was to say that I have only the connections inside one of those parts. I don't want to do it here, but just to show you that you could do that. You could also go in and say you want to take it page by page, because maybe you've divided your project into some logical chapters. Or you could, what I think a lot of people would do, say that first I want to mount my potentials. That's my power supply and in this project here it's my phases. So for instance I might want to mount my L1 and my N, and then I could click in the normal Windows way. And you see now only the connections that are either L1 or N. Then when I want to install, or when I want to mount this panel here, I simply go up and say now this wire here is mounted, and I can click on this check and then you can see it's been mounted. And then watch this window up here, because this connection here now comes from 1.2.Q1:1, that's a connector on Q1, and it goes to a connector on Q2. And you can see in this window up here that I have two wires in this connector. That might influence something about how to mount it, so you might not want to tighten it at first. And you can also see down here that the potential is L1. It hasn't got a wire number because it's got a potential name instead. But and then you can go down and say this next wire I want to mount that too, and simply click mount it. Then what you can see in this window, and I think I just want to zoom out here, is that I want to have it marked in my picture here, mounted just as you do when you go, no that's not this one, highlight mounted, the same thing as you do when you have it in the book. So you can see now that the ones that I have mounted, they are having a green highlight. Then what I wanted to show in the window actually was the ones that were not mounted, because as soon as it's mounted I think it's I don't want to have them in a list because it'll simply be too much. And then I can say I want to mount this one, click, and I want to mount this one, click, and I want to mount this one, and click, 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 and then it starts all over again with my N. And of course I also want to mount them, and then it will be marked in my diagram here. Then I could go up and say that I wanted to mount the other potentials. I could also, instead of selecting new potential, go in and say I want to select all my wires. And when I have all my wires, you see that some of them have a potential, that's okay, some of them can be anything. But I could go down and say I want to have only those with a specific color. And some of them, as you see here, they have a pink color, and they are the only ones that I would have here. And then I could go down and say I want them to be mounted. Then the next one, I don't want to mount that one because maybe I have a question. Maybe I don't know exactly what to do with this one. Do I have any questions? Is it the right type or whatever? And then I can mark it as not mounted. I could also go down, and that's another way of having it, and say this, I don't just have a question, or I have a question, but it's stuck, so I need to go somewhere and go to the constructor of this project and say, please help me. And in that way, instead of just mounting, I can go down and say that I have another status to those wires here. Then the ones with the status is possible to later and say I want to see all the wires that are ignored, or I want to see all the ones that are stuck. So I don't have to remember which wire I had a question or an issue to. I can simply find them because they have been marked in a specific way. Back to this one with the not mounted. When I have all the not mounted wires here, you can see that I can sort in different ways. I have the potential, which you saw that already, but I can go down and say, for instance, I only want to see the ones with a certain type. And then if I select the type here, you can see that only the ones with the type will be listed up here. That means that if you have a lot of wires which you assigned any type to, then you can simply sort them out by type, and you don't have to use a color code as I did here. And the same thing with all the wire numbers and that. You can simply select yourself how you want to sort all those wires in the project. I have, as you saw here, the all connections. I have those with the potential on, and I have wires with or without a type, with or without a wire number. I could have jumpers, and then I would only have the jumpers in the project. You see the small one here is marked. I could have all cable connections. They would be here. And I have all my cables, so I could simply select a cable at a time, and then I would only have cables in the connections in this cable here, and then I could mount them. So different ways of sorting all my connections, and that's what the mounting assistant is about in part number one. Now I'll close it, and then you will see what happens if somebody makes a change to the project here. Up to now, I was the guy or the person in the workshop making the physical mounting of this panel. But now, I'll go back and then I'll be the designer of this project. And then what can I do? For instance, if I go in and say, I think I'll find one of those wires here. This wire, I already mounted that, but now I'll make a change in the project. So I'll delete it, and I think I mounted this one too. So I'll simply delete it, and then I will save the project. Save, and see what happens now. I remembered to save the project, and when I did so, I can again go up and open the mounting assistant. And remember, I just made some changes in the project. When I go out, and now I'll again become the guy in the workshop, I'll open the order number 117, and then it comes up and says this wire here from to, which was already mounted, I changed it, or somebody else, that's me, Kirsten, changed it, and this wire as well was mounted and it was changed. So now remember that I have to remove those two wires which were already in the panel. So I get a message, and that's it. I click OK. I could print them and do whatever, but right now I'll just click OK. That means that I should remove that wire, and then I will go on and make the rest of the connections. And let's just agree that we've done that now. Then, after having mounted all the connections, I have some post-processing to do. All my components, I need to do something to at least some of them. There might be some timers that I need to adjust. There could be motor protection that I needed to adjust, whatever. But all my components in this project are in this list here. And what I do now is that I simply say that whatever I need to do to this one is done. Whatever I need to do to this component is done. And if I want to do something to this component, you can see I still have the references here. So if I want to look up something in the diagram, I can use a project just as I would normally do. And whenever I finish, I'll simply say done. If I need to look up something, I could either look up, for instance, in the object lister, if nothing is stated here, I could click this one, this is the object lister, and then I would have a list here which might state something else that I wanted to do to this component. This one is not interesting, so I'll just close a window here. And then I would simply say that it's done, and then that's it. If I want to see something in the database, and I think this one is in my database, I could go in here, I could show the component in the database, and then you can see here that I have everything that whatever I wanted to do. So when I have seen everything, I can again go in and say this one is done, 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 and again I have exactly the same options that I had early on to have a question, and then I could go into the design of the project and ask any question that I wanted to do. And that's it. I hope that you could see that this mounting assistant could be an assistant to you too. There are still features in it that are not explained in this video, but please feel free to download it and then try it out for yourself.